Deadline has passed for countries to apply for founding membership in the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. As of now, 46 applications have been received, including major Western powers. CCTV's Tang Bo takes a closer look at the breakdown of the member countries and the mission of the China-led bank.
Turning eastwards, from the moment that the UK decided to be part of Asia Infrastructure Investment Bank, or AIIB, a raft of Western major powers have followed suit. France, Italy, Germany, New Zealand and Australia have jumped on board.
I think that it's excellent that these institutions are becoming established and are making investment. What we see in our world is a need for more investment institutions and more investment, particularly in infrastructure and capacity, so we can sustain the high rates of growth that we need to provide the public services that our constituents rightly want.
Currently, the AIIB has secured more than 40 member countries, with more applications due.
The return of infrastructure investment is long-term and stable. It's different from commercial investments that aims at quick and promising rewards in a short period of time. Safe and stable investment return is vital for long-term investors, such as those major Western powers, especially in the infrastructure investment market.
Many countries in Asia have developing economies and are in need of infrastructure spending that will help accelerate growth further. It is estimated that the region requires more than $800 billion annually to develop infrastructure. But the financing capacities of current international financial institutions are falling short.
The current major international financial institutions, such as World Bank, have a wide range of financing programs to work on. Their goals are mainly poverty relief. So the investment return rate has been quite low, which therefore has weakened their financing capacity. So the AIIB is complementary to the major institutions in infrastructure investment.
Which is why the AIIB is now drawing worldwide attention with the clear objective of infrastructure investment and does not make one country dominant in the decision-making process.
This initiative led by China has come in for criticism from some quarters, but the Chinese leadership has consistently reiterated its position on the bank that the aim is to facilitate China's cooperation with its neighbors and bring economic prosperity and social progress to more countries and more people. Tang Bo, CCTV, Beijing.